find the intro.
I would be pure.
answer all our questions and heal all our hurts. It is difficult for us to deal with the knowledge that discipleship requires patience and perseverance. Jesus' own disciples struggled with his teachings. It took a long time for them to understand fully what Jesus was saying and how they were to respond. We are no different. The words of Jesus take time for us to comprehend. Forgive us, Lord, when we are so impatient, and when we just want to get on with it, and be where your reaction is. Help us to understand the commitment we make in discipleship through the rocky times and the smooth seas alike. Push us in our ministry of help and compassion to do more than we ever thought we could do in helping others. Give to us that extra measure of faith and commitment that we may truly serve you by serving others. In Jesus' name we pray.
Please take a moment for your own silent confession. Amen. This is your assurance of pardon. Even though you doubt and question, God's love is poured on you, in you, and through you to others. Rest assured in God's presence and love for you that will never fail or abandon you. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are healed, restored, and forgiven. Amen. We worship our Lord by presenting to him our gifts, tithes, and offerings. Thank you.
Almighty God, you bless us endlessly. We ask, Lord, that you continue to bless us, and that you bless these, our gifts. May these gifts somehow express your love to the world around us. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Blessings. We're blessed, right?
Right.
I want to hear how you've been blessed lately. I heard a story about a tree falling down. Everybody hear about the story that...
A lot of them came out and helped.
That's another blessing.
That is a blessing.
You're blessed. Any other blessings?
Roy and I had a blessing this morning. Our little grandson in New Hampshire woke us up with FaceTime. Very tough.
What time did he wake you up?
About 7 o'clock.
Wasn't too bad, was it?
That was a blessing.
Yeah. I admire you for FaceTiming. I'm not very good at that. Other blessings. Technology, that's a blessing also.
It is.
Other blessings.
Yes. A niece and nephew visit over the weekend.
You had some niece and nephew visiting. This weekend or last?
Just left, that's why I was late.
Last night.
They spent the night. Okay, they dropped their son off at college in Ohio and were on their way home with their other two sons. Oh. My sister's oldest. So we had fun.
Good.
I was blessed last night with a family wiener roast and just a nice evening of visiting.
Wiener roast.
Yeah.
And what did you have with them?
What did we have with it?
Yes. Sounds like a picnic.
I get hungry.
What about s'mores?
No, we didn't do s'mores. We have a nice bar. We go to my mom's on the bar.
Okay. I'm disappointed. No s'mores. We get this side.
We got to visit with people from our park in Florida. For on Thursday, had a good time.
Good.
Yeah. Enjoyed.
The blessings are there. Yeah. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us and helping us to be aware of those blessings. We need to count those blessings. We need to count them. We need them. Help us, Lord, to be more aware, more and more aware of how you walk with us and how you bless us. Thank you. In Christ we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We'll almost ask for another one. What about concerns? Oh, that's good. Nobody has any concerns.
Lily got her braces on Friday.
Braces?
Yeah. It's a new adventure, so we're... Figure that out.
Sorry.
Find out a lot of things you can't eat.
Can't eat?
I can eat s'mores.
You cannot eat s'mores?
You got ice cream.
I have a friend who has dementia.
Yes, that's tough, isn't it? Yes. Other concerns?
I have an aunt. She's about 88 years old. She's
how old?
I think she's about 88.
88. Yeah. She's older than I am.
She's also having dementia problems.
She what?
She's also having dementia problems.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. That's a challenge.
Yeah. Sometimes she's been... Her husband there, and she's off somewhere, but she's actually kind of my sister was talking to her, and she says, I'm in Newcastle.
Yeah.
And my sister said, well, call me on your home, so you can't be a new gal. So.
Yeah, it's a challenge.
Yeah,
it's a real
so
challenge.
Kind of out there, her and Mary with her, so.
And Ruth is traveling. She's safe travels for
her. Thank you.
Mark and Cheryl Ann leave tomorrow for a 3-week trip, so.
You're not excited about that.
It's not a vacation if you retire. It's just a trip.
No, it's
just a trip. My, I had a brother-in-law that said, how in the world can you call it a vacation when you're retired?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't use that language, but. We're in church, so I better clean that up. Almighty God, we give you thanks and praise. You are with us, not just during the blessings, but you are with us as we walk through the challenges of life, through the pain and the struggle, the grief, through the dangers. You walk with us. You walk with us. And with you with us, we can keep going. And really, Lord, when we really realize that you are walking with us, we can celebrate. Even in the struggle, even in the pain, even in the grief, we can celebrate because we know that you love us and that you're present with us and you will see us through. You don't abandon us. You walk with us. I'm convinced, Lord, that you know the pain of human life. You know the struggles that we have. You know the grief that we experience. You know the anxiety. You know when we're in the hospital, when we're recovering. You know when a loved one has dementia. You know when we have memory problems. You know all things, you know, and you care. We may think that you do not care because we don't like the pain, we don't like this, we don't like the other, and we say that you don't care, but that's not true. You do care. And your care, your love for us, is stronger than what we realize. You carry us and you bless us. And you give us the strength and the courage and the determination, the reassurance, all of that and more so that we can keep on keeping on. Not only that, you bless us enough so that we can be a blessing to others. Help us to remember, Lord, that we are not just individuals living our own little life. We are reaching out. We are making a difference in the world every day that we live. Just to make a positive, good, blessed difference in the world. You are an amazing God, and we just give you thanks and praise for all the gifts that you give to us, the gift of prayer. Hear us now as together we pray that prayer that Jesus taught, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty God, as we open your word, as we read your word, as we think about your word, and as I talk with these people, converse with these people about your word, we ask, Lord, that you be with us. Help us to listen for your voice. Help me to get out of the way. Help us to listen for your voice. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen. We have some scripture. There we go, 15. I'm sorry. Ephesians 5, 15 to 20. Be careful then, very careful then, how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So I read that scripture, and if you picked up another piece of paper that has another scripture, that also is from Paul's letter to the Ephesians. I read that scripture and both of them, and I wrestled with it, and wrestled with it, and wrestled with it, because it seems to me we do those things. For instance, if you want to look at the other side of that sheet that I gave, Ephesians 4, chapter 20, or Ephesians 4, chapter 4, yeah, 25, verse, yeah, 4:25 through 5:2. What this adds up to then is this: no more lies. Who wants to lie? No more pretense. We don't lie. We don't pretend. We don't. Tell your neighbor the truth. Tell your neighbor the truth with love, though. I would put that in. In Christ's body, we are all connected to each other, after all. When you lie to others, you end up lying to yourself. We know this. Go ahead and be angry. That's new to me, because I was taught, no, you suppress the anger. Go ahead and be angry. You do well to be angry, but do not use your anger as fuel for revenge. And don't stay angry. Don't go to bed angry. Don't give the devil that kind of foothold in your life. Did you used to make ends meet by stealing? Well, no more. Get an honest job so that you can help others who cannot work. Watch the way you talk. Let nothing foul or dirty come out of your mouth. Say only what helps. Each word is a gift. Do not grieve God. Don't break his heart. His Holy Spirit moving and breathing in you is the most intimate part of your life, making you fit for himself. Don't take such a gift for granted. Make a clean break with all cutting, backbiting, profane talk. Be gentle with one another, sensitive, forgive one another as quickly and thoroughly as God in Christ forgave you. Watch what God does, then you do it, like children who learn proper behavior from their parents. Mostly what God does is love you. Keep company with him and learn a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us. His love was not cautious, but extravagant. He did not love in order to get something from us, but to give everything of himself to us. Love like that. We know all those things. So I wrestled and wrestled and wrestled with this, both of these scriptures, and I said to myself, what can I say to these people who know all this? This is nothing new, because You know it and you practice it. Well, I can't say I practice all of it. I go back over that chapter 4 verse of scripture. Well, sometimes I don't, sometimes I'm not entirely honest. If I know something and I know that it's going to upset Sue, I have to say to myself, I'm not going to say that. That's not being honest. But I don't want to spend the time or the energy to work it through, to work it through to, with Sue, that she doesn't get hurt and all of that. So I just keep quiet. You ever done that? Yeah. Is that being honest and truthful? Not quite.
Discerning.
Discerning, yes. And then years ago, when I first became a pastor, maybe the second year that I was at the starting, it was a part-time church. That's how I started. This man came into church, and I was there, other people were there. He came into church, went to his sister, and he berated her out loud, so everybody heard it, right in front of everybody. And I think my chin must have dropped, because he turned to me and he said, "What? I'm supposed to be honest. We're supposed to be honest." And I wasn't wise enough to say, "Yeah, we're supposed to be honest, but more important, we're supposed to be loving." And what he did was not loving. So I put that in there, that I think we need to be very loving. I think that's number one. Go ahead and be angry. I already said that. I wasn't taught that. So I still struggle with my anger. I still have anger. The anger feelings are feelings that we have, and apparently God wants us to have those feelings because God is the one that created us, and we have those feelings. So I don't think it's right to suppress it. What is right is how we express that. And again, that's a challenge. How do we express the anger that we have in a loving way so we don't hurt the other person? All of that's important. This is hard work. This is not an easy scripture. Yes, it says don't stay angry. Don't go to bed angry. That was very, very important to Carol, my wife. Don't let the devil get a foothold. Certainly the devil can get a foothold when we get angry. And then he talks about stealing. And I don't think that any of us would dream of stealing. I wouldn't. And yet, I really, really think about it. I read something years ago about a man who realized that if he cut out of work an hour earlier, he was stealing from his employer. And then if I take that a step further, and I hear God saying to me, "Willard, I want you to do this. I want you to do that. And I only do this and I don't do that," am I stealing from God? Am I stealing from that other person? Depends on how we look at the scripture. This scripture is important. It's scripture. Don't grieve God. We do not. None of us want to hurt God. We don't. Be careful. Don't grieve God. Don't break his heart. His Holy Spirit, I love this, his Holy Spirit moving and breathing in you and in me, each one of us, is the most intimate part of us, preparing ourselves for him. That's beautiful. I love the way that that is reads. Don't take such a gift for granted. Make a clean break from all cutting, backbiting, profane talk, you know, I used to use that kind of talk. Anymore, I hear that kind of talk, and then it just, I can't handle it. I know somebody that was going to have a party yesterday because the Steelers were on, and he was invited some people, and I said, "What time is it?" And he says, "You really don't want to come, Willard, because there's going to be language there that you won't like." So apparently, people know that I have something there that I don't want to be in that atmosphere. So, all of those words are important. They're scripture, so of course they're important. I wrestled with this, and there's a couple of things that came to my mind. One, it made me think back to when I was not a Christian, or when I just became a Christian. And it's, for me, it's a growing process, and I'm still growing. I'm not there yet. I used language that I would never dream of using today. I did some things that were horrible, and I wouldn't want to do them today. So I can see in my mind, I can see the difference of what I was and what I am today. And that somehow encourages me to keep on going in this journey of life. So I think that it's good to kind of review our mind, in our minds, what our life has been. And the other side is that, like I said earlier, people are observing us all the time. People are observing us all the time. And we are to make a difference in the world. As Christians, we are called to make a difference in the world that we are living in. And scripture says the days are evil. I think the days are evil today. Maybe they aren't the same evil as what they were in Paul's day when he wrote this letter, but I think the days are evil. I, for one, am very, very concerned about where our country is and where it's going. It's frightening to me. We are called to make a difference. And what we do in the world that we live in makes a difference. What we say and how we say it, I've been saying this for years and years, what we say and how we say it makes a whole lot of difference. As Christians, we need to be expressing God's love. As Christians, we are called to make a difference in the world. And yes, you are making a difference in the world. Please know, I'm not saying that you are not, but please be aware that every time that we step out of this building, people are observing us. What we are as Christians really does count. It counts to other people. More important, I think it counts to God. We don't want to hurt God. We want to be God's people. Would you pray with me? Almighty God, you are beyond our conception. And yet, we know that you love us and that your love is greater than what we know, but we know that you love us. We talk about some of the blessings that we share this week, this morning. We are blessed because you love us. And we can see that we are blessed. We can know without a doubt that we are blessed. You bless us, Lord. Help us to be a blessing to others. Help us to keep in mind what we are doing. Help us to keep in mind what we are saying, how we say it. Help us, Lord, to somehow reach out with your love today and tomorrow and in all of our tomorrows. In Christ we pray. And all God's people say,
Amen.
Closing hymn. Take thou our minds, dear Lord. You people are teaching me new hymns.
Give us the mind of Christ throughout.
And every one of us today. And may we be aware of that present today, tomorrow, and all of our tomorrows. Amen.
Amen. Amen.